Who are the world's greatest watercross racers? 75 miles per hour, no brakes. Hang on tight. We're about to crown your pro watercross world champions. Coming up next on the CBS Sports Network. Welcome to Naples, Florida, here on the Paradise Coast. We're here at Sugden Regional Park. This is the Pro Watercross World Championships powered by Broward Motorsports. I'm Haley Shanley, calling the action from here on the sidelines here today, and we are celebrating 25 years of pro watercross racing. Joining me is pro watercross ambassador PK Ewing. PK, talk to me about Pro Watercross's environmentally aware initiatives going on.
Well, as you know, Pro Watercross is the premier racing sanctioning body, and as such, we have to set the example both to our athletes and to the public alike. So we have a series of initiatives that are out there that will help us educate the public and make an impact everywhere we go. We try to leave the environment better than we found it.
And I understand you have some prototypes debuting this weekend.
We have a few devices, one of which is called the PK Pack. When we're out on the waterways, we always encounter trash, but it's never convenient or easy to pick it up and haul it back. But the PK pouch attaches to your jet ski out of the way, and it allows us to do that.
Thanks, PK. For more information on how to get involved, visit prowatercross.org. With that, it's about time to go racing. Let's take a look at the three classes that are going to be featured here today. Your Pro Ski GP. These stand-up watercrafts are going to feature two different kinds of engines, your two strokes, 1300cc maximum, or your four strokes with a 900cc turbo or 1500cc max. These machines are going to reach speeds up to 75 miles per hour. Blaster GP. These two-seated watercrafts are modified to reach maximum performance. Featuring three-cylinder engines, these machines are maneuverable and nimble, reaching speeds up to 75 miles per hour. You too can be a racer with Pro Runabout Box Stock, a great way to get started. These are strictly out of the box and available for purchase at your local dealer. These sit-down watercrafts reach speeds of 80 miles per hour. We're going to show you what it's like to go for a ride on one of these personal watercrafts. I'm going to hand it back upstairs for our lap of the day.
We're on board with Dustin Motsuris on that Commander number 50 going into the first turn. Dustin on the inside, he's going to take the inside split, and you can see it's just a grinding left-hand sweeper all the way into that right-hand inside section of the racetrack, then through a section of slalom turns, essentially. He will work his way through these turns, right-hand, left-hand, another right-hander. Then he's going to come around, make a left-hander onto the front straightaway.
As he drives down the front straightaway, he'll have a left-right combination. Then he'll make the U-turn here to the left. This is the first lap. He'll bypass the log jump, follow the double yellows to the right onto the back section of the course. Here's the split course. He's choosing the inside split. Left-right, slalom. He'll head to the back straightaway.
And then he goes on to the jet trim, bitch and stitch, and back straightaway. And he's going to enter that now and then wick it up full throttle, heading in to the split section of the course. One more time, he's going to go to the inside split. And that is a lap of the day.
Stick around later in the show. We're going to see some high-flying freestyle action. This is the Pro Watercross World Championships powered by Broward Motorsports.
Pro Watercross World Championships powered by Broward Motorsports on CBS Sports Network is sponsored by Naples Marco Island Everglades, Florida's paradise, by Broward Motorsports, you gotta ride, and by Hull Speed, official marine coating of the World Championships. Go faster, go cleaner.
If you like having fun on the water, you're going to love Florida's Paradise Coast. From fast-paced water sports to leisurely, laid-back adventures, this place has you covered. And when it's time to come ashore, the action is just as exciting, with award-winning dining, luxurious spas, and countless ways to play. So escape to a place where your options are as endless as the water. and vacation well, friend, on Florida's Paradise Coast, Naples, Marco Island, and the Everglades.
Broward Motorsports, South Florida's premier power sports dealer with four locations, Davie, Fort Lauderdale, West Palm Beach, and Tequesta. A huge selection of new and used motorcycles, UTVs, ATVs, boats, trailers, and personal watercraft. Log on, check out the selection, and request a quote. Broward Motorsports will not be undersold. The best staff in the industry are ready to serve you. We also feature a customizing department to build the machine of your dreams. At Broward Motorsports, you gotta ride.
Delivers now with same day express delivery on the things you need most, and free delivery on over a million more. No membership required. Want it even faster? Shop online and we'll have it ready for pickup in as little as 2 hours. Or tell us when you'll be home and get whatever you need delivered to your doorstep. This is how doers get more done. Just say when, where, and how you want it. The Home Depot. More saving, more doing.
I've got a big family.
Okay, pick your head that way.
No, smile.
That's a lot of people and pets to make happy this holiday. So I'm always looking for ways to save. With Chewy.com, I get low prices on all of my pet food and supplies. I find amazing deals on dog food for Dasher, cat toys for Comet, and biscuits for Bob. Even the shipping is free. With all that money saved, I can get a little something extra for everyone on my list.
Make their holiday dreams come true. Save 30% on your first order today at Chewy, where pet lovers shop.
Welcome back here in beautiful Naples, located on the west coast of Florida. This is the Pro Watercross World Championships powered by Broward Motorsports. Let's check out Moto 2 of Blaster GP. We're going to hand it upstairs to you guys.
Number 13. Oh, Sam gets a decent start, but it's not going to be. He may take the whole shot on the outside. Whoa.
Oh, he's right there.
No, it's a battle on the outside. The inside split looks like number 14 with the hole shot. That's Keith Dill.
No, that's Devin Farthing on the inside.
Yeah, Farthing on the outside looks like Hayden Skellett.
Oh, this is going to be good.
Farthing and Skellett, the youngsters, going at it here. It is Skellett, 296 with the race lead.
By using that outside split, O'Neill goes way wide. Sam Heaney not having his best day.
Man, the youth movement is underway here in Naples. The 14 and 15-year-olds are dominating. Well, Hayden Skellett's going to take a well-earned win here in Moto number 2.
This is how they finished in Moto 2. Revan Harris tried hard. Hayden Skellett still won.
We just witnessed Blaster GP Moto 2, and what an exciting race that was. Let's check out the third and final moto of Blaster GP.
Going into Blaster GP Moto number 3, keep an eye on Devin Farthing. He is a young charger, and he is going to be on the gas. Revan Harris with a 1 and a 2. Keep an eye on Revan Harris.
And
he has been the fastest out there today, and he is right in front of us here. Oh, and Revan Harris gets a rough start. Not a good start for Revan Harris in this
Mimi gets a hole shot on the outside. Oh!
Number 1 with the hole shot. That is Devin Farthing. Taking the hole shot on that Speed Zone Yamaha Blaster on the inside split. Young Devin Farthing, the son of multi-time national and world champion Dustin Farthing, gets the hole shot and the lead. What an exciting time for the Farthing family as young Devin takes the hole shot here in Moto number 3.
Keith
here comes
Dill.
14 Dill on the gas.
Then Hayden Skellett, Revan Harris, Sam Neamey. The double 7, Glenn Young.
Oh, Hayden Skellett, visor flying up in the air. Somehow that thing got knocked up. That's a funny look out there, but young Hayden on the gas, but he is getting pressured right now by Revan Harris, and they go to the different splits. Harris to the outside, Skellett to the inside. really those two are the ones that are fighting for the world championship. Might not end up that way at the end of the day, but right now, those two have been the fastest.
Skellet made the move on the inside. That worked for him. Now lots for top speed. Revan Harris way down, but he is not pulling him at all.
Well, they were equal going into the split on the outside of the track, so that really cost Revan Harris substantially here early in moto number three. But it's young Devin Farthing on boat number one out in front and leading the way here in moto number three. What a ride for Devin Farthing, 15 years old, out of Ackworth, Georgia, and he is on the gas. Here comes Hayden Skellet behind him in second. Revan Harris trying to get around 14 Keith Dill, and he makes the move.
Well, I got to tell you, that was Keith Dill trying to get around Revan Harris.
Revan Harris, man.
Having none of that. Oh, Harris made the move up. As we look forward, look out there. Farthing just gone, but Skellet taking the inside. Harris follows.
Farthing, Skellet, and Harris, the young guns, out in front right now, running 1, 2, 3. 15 years old. Skellet's 15 years old, and Harris is 14. So, wow, look at these youngsters pull away from the rest of the field here in moto number three. And this is what it's all about here for the world championship. Right now, Devin Farthing, said Dustin Farthing. How many times am I going to say that?
A couple more. How can you not?
I've said Dustin Farthing's name about 2 billion times in my life, so it's tough, but Devin Farthing out in front. And here comes Skellet in second, and Revan Harris just riding that blaster for all it's worth in third place right now. All three of these kids just laying those boats over. And the old guys, Dill and Nemi, used to be battling for the lead right now. Let's go down to Haley on the beach.
Thanks, guys. One word that can accurately be used to describe 30-year veteran Sam Nemi is passionate. He's had a phenomenal year, but currently he's sidelined this weekend to foster the future of our sport, his son Sammy Nemi. Now, this is his first race back. He's been out with an injury. Just a few months ago, he had surgery on not one, but both of his feet. While he's been confined to a wheelchair, he's been participating in therapy, which is what ultimately brought him back here today. We couldn't be more thrilled that he's back here racing with us, regardless of how he finishes. Talk about a comeback story, guys.
Yeah, no question about it. That is very, very true. We are pumped to see Sammy back on the race course. He was sidelined for a bit, as you mentioned, with some surgery on his feet, and now he's back healing up and charging out here again. Great to see him. We love young Sammy Nemi, as well as his dad, Sam, no question about it. And but right now, look at Farthing out in front, charging, Skellet in second, and then Revan Harris in third. And these guys battling for the world title right now. Skellet with a fourth and a first. Harris with a one and a two.
And Harris taking the outside split, Rick. Hayden took the inside. Skellet has been boiling the water on the inside. And Harris says, that's it. I got to go to the outside. I can't be in his pump wash. Skellet will get there first. Here comes Harris.
Oh, look at Harris, Kurt.
He's making a move, but the top speed of Hayden Skellet will not be denied.
Down that jet trim, bitching, stitching back straightaway. I'll tell you what, those guys are going at it. They are riding the blasters for everything they have, pinned the entire way around this racetrack here in Naples. And Devin Farthing is going to have company here in a short amount of time.
Oh, yeah. And I'll tell you what, look, watch Hayden Skellet as he comes by. You think that young man's neck's got it, not going to be sore at the end of this race?
With that visor
up. We got a rider down right in the race. In the race lane,
he's out of the
Quick
way.
Quickstep gets him out of the way.
Nope.
Everybody's safe.
Everybody's okay. Nobody lost really any time. And Skellet went wide around that right-hander, allowed Revan Harris to catch him a little bit. Now they go on to the split. Revan Harris decides once again to take the outside. Skellet on the inside on that back split on the back part of the racetrack here. Meanwhile, Devin Farthing out in front, but oh, he is going to have company real shortly as Skellet and Revan Harris are on the gas, the young guns leading the way here in Naples.
We got another battle going on further in the back. Keith Dill, former national champion, and Sammy Nemi have been battling. Nemi got by, and he has just yarded them. Nemi starting to move up into battle for fourth position. He came up really quickly.
Yeah, Sammy, an outstanding talent in his class, we know, hasn't been able to race for a little bit because of that surgery. He's getting back into it, starting to feel things here in Moto number three, and he's looking way better. But out in front, this is a battle for the ages, a young age. The 14 and 15-year-olds going at it here, and it's led by Devin Farthing.
Yeah, Nimi in that fourth position now. Christopher Landis off the track. Keith Gill, he's doing everything he can, but at 47, trying to chase these 15-year-olds, it's just not going to happen.
No, each lap now, Skellett's taking the inside split, Harris the outside split, and here comes Skellett now. Skellett coming up behind Farthing. Devin Farthing's got his hands full of Hayden Skellett, and Hayden is a charger.
It.
Makes a mistake, swings wide, loses grip around that turn. But here we go. They are getting bunched up right now. This is a battle. Farthing, Skellett, Harris, 1, 2, 3. Winding their way around onto the front straightaway, down the front straightaway. Here comes our leader, number one, Farthing, followed by 296 Skellett and 100 Revan Harris. Wow, what a battle here in Blaster GP, Kurt.
Well, I'll tell you what, Rick. Hayden Skellett, as he came off that back straightaway, 70-plus miles an hour, that boat stuck. He lifted his body off the boat. He held onto the bars, drove himself back onto that machine and stayed with it. Hayden Skellett, he is a top talent, no question. And look at this. Watch as Skellett makes that move. Farthing going to get on that straightaway. Harris going to be there, but here's Skellett.
Skellett likes that inside split. The other two taking the outside split of the back part of the racetrack. Now as they come around to the inside part of the track, it's going to be Farthing, Skellett, and Harris all taking the inside split. Still running 1, 2, 3, Kurt.
It surprises me, Rick, that Revan Harris isn't trying that outside split because
I agree.
Was so good earlier on. He was making moves there. Oh, Farthing going a little wide. Skellett goes underneath him.
I agree with you. I'm surprised nobody else is trying a different split, especially Revan Harris, because he needs to do something. He's staying right where he's at. He's not gaining any ground. He caught up, and now he's kind of stayed in that position. Time to try something new. Now, he keeps taking that outside split here on the back part of the track. Let's see if he does so again. I think he should follow Skellett on the inside, personally, but he's not going to.
Hayden Skellett, this time through, I believe he's going to be really close to Devin Farthing as they come out. Watch it as Skellett comes by. He and Farthing going to be close to side by side.
Down that jet trim, bitching, stitching back straightaway. It is Farthing, Skellett, and Harris running 1, 2, 3. What a battle between these three young chargers.
And there he goes. Harris is on the outside.
He was listening to us, Kurt.
He must have a radio on, and Skellett
I think
is getting held up by Farthing now.
Oh, yeah.
There's nothing Skellett can do as Revan Harris is making a move.
Here comes Harris on the outside. Harris has got some speed. He gets by Skellett. Harris goes into second, sets his sights on Farthing. Revan Harris on the gas here.
Are we prophetic or what?
I
said prophetic, not pathetic.
Well, maybe a little of both. We just wanted Revan. Oh, and he swings way wide, makes a mistake, opens the door for Skellett.
Skellett sticks it. He's got the inside. He's got to ride it better than he's ridden it all week.
This is the final lap. White flag is out. Here we go. This is going to be for all the marbles here, the World Championship in Naples, Florida, in Blaster GP. Right now, Revan Harris sits in the driver's seat. He's got a 2-1 score coming into this final. And if I'm not, 1-2 for Revan Harris. If he can hang on to second place, he is going to be the world champion.
Skellett taking the outside. He's the only option he has with the rider in front of him.
Good move by
Skellett. Has got to ride this like he's never ridden an outside split before. Here comes Revan Harris. Skellett's going to be close. He's going to have some speed.
No.
But not enough.
Oh, Revan Harris takes second.
Wow.
And that'll be the world championship for Revan Harris. And we will be back in just a minute to talk to our winner.
Two different products that lower the temperature in your cooling system.
Great for bugs on the front of the car.
You got your wax here, you got your power wax.
Generators, pressure washers, lawnmowers, you name it, they got it for it. VP Racing is now offering Optanium Unleaded, which is safer for your street cars, safe for your O2 sensors, your catalytic converters, to get an increase in octane boost by pouring straight to the gas.
When it comes to using data, everyone is different, which is why Xfinity Mobile is a different kind of wireless network that lets you design your own data. Choose unlimited, shared data, or mix lines of each, and switch any line anytime. Giving you more choice and control compared to other top wireless carriers. And now get $250 off when you buy a new Samsung phone during Xfinity Mobile Beyond Black Friday. Plus, you can save up to $400 a year. Click, call, or visit a store today.
Casper is inviting everyone to shop Black Friday before Black Friday. Now you can get the award-winning mattress for 10% off. The one so comfortable, over 50,000 people gave it a perfect 5-star rating. So, stop daydreaming, because now is the perfect time to try it. Beat the Black Friday rush, and save 10% on any award-winning Casper mattress. Try it for 100 nights, risk-free, with free shipping and returns. Visit Casper.com today.
Who even decades later wonder if that really happened. Relive the moments that shaped the sport as CBS celebrates the 150th year of college football.
If you're behind on your mortgage payments, threatened with foreclosure, denied a loan modification, or have been the victim of a predatory loan, the Stop Foreclosure Group can help. You have rights, and we have options. Call now for a free consultation.
Skellig's going to be close. He's going to have some speed.
No, but not enough.
Oh, Revan Harris takes second.
Wow.
And that'll be the world championship for Revan Harris.
Welcome back. Joining me is a pair of winners here. I have Devin Farthing, a Blaster GP Moto 3 winner. That one was far from easy. We had drama and excitement. How did you manage to power through that fatigue there? That was a long race.
I just made sure I stuck tight to the buoys and got on the gas when I was on the straightaways just to make sure I could keep the distance that I had.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
And now your world champion, Revan Harris. Congratulations on this one. Consistency was key, but what else came into play for you there?
Just keep charging till the end, and we made a move on Hayden, and we got him, and we're able to get the championship.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Stick around later in the show. We're going to see some high-flying freestyle action. This is the Pro Watercross World Championships powered by Broward Motorsports.
It's a beautiful day in Erie. You're gonna love fall. You're gonna love Erie. Request your free Erie PA Adventure Guide. Call or go online today.
If you like having fun on the water, you're going to love Florida's Paradise Coast. From fast-paced water sports to leisurely, laid-back adventures, this place has you covered. And when it's time to come ashore, the action is just as exciting, with award-winning dining, luxurious spas, and countless ways to play. So escape to a place where your options are as endless as the water. And vacation well, friend, on Florida's Paradise Coast, Naples, Marco Island, and the Everglades.
On an urgent Fansville by Dr. Pepper.
What do we got?
Took a goalpost to the head while celebrating.
What a quick comeback by State.
Who's State?
Wait.
He's got fan knees. Forgot he's a fan.
Help.
Somebody get him a Dr. Pepper. Stat!
Who's Dr. Pepper?
Your husband's gone.
Whoa, that's good. Have you tried it? What's it called? Dr. Pepper?
Dr. Pepper, the official drink of Fansville.
What's the NFL's competitive edge? It's the Sleep Number 360 Smart Bed. On sale now.
Can it help me fall asleep faster?
Yes, by gently warming your feet.
Can it help keep me asleep?
Absolutely. It intelligently senses your movements and automatically adjusts to keep you effortlessly comfortable.
Will it help me raise my game?
Yep.
So, you can really promise better sleep?
Not promise, prove.
So I can do my best for these guys?
Yes, and those guys.
Here we go.
Sleep Number. This is not a bed. It's proven quality sleep.
Christmas trees try so hard.
lights and ornaments and little choo-choo trains. Come on. The best trees, they kind of only need two things. Peanut butter and chocolate. Not sorry. Reese's.
This is a clear aligner. Actually, it's a nighttime clear aligner. They're new and only available at Smile Direct Club. Go from a smile like this to a smile like this while you sleep for 60% less than braces. New nighttime clear aligners, only at Smile Direct Club.
Hey, hon, I'm going to go grab a pickup game with the guys, okay?
Okay, live it up.
Take in the car.
Wait, what? Have fun, sweetie.
Yeah, okay. I love you.
Smart Liner offer the ultimate smart protection. Easy removal, cleaning, and install. It's smart. It's Smart Liner.
Welcome to Naples, Florida, on Florida's West Coast, and we're here at Sugden Regional Park. This is the Pro Watercross World Championships powered by Broward Motorsports. I love this class. You can head down to your local dealer and pick one up today to get involved. This is Pro Runabout Box Stock Moto number 2.
How many Snyder fans do we have?
Well, Snyder gets a whole shot on the inside. Iataska on the outside. So here we go. Picking up where we left off for Moto number 1. Look at that acceleration by Iataska on that outside.
Troy stuck it a little.
Troy makes a mistake.
Oh, the crowd's yelling behind us.
Here comes Arminio. Arminio charging hard. Here comes Iataska.
Iataska
takes the lead.
Wow, Rick Blake, how close can it be?
And I'll say it right now. Nothing against Arminio at all, but if Troy hadn't made that one bobble, I think he'd still be chasing him.
I think you're right.
Hands together for your Moto winner, Arminio Iataska.
What an exciting race that was. This is Pro Runabout Box Stock Moto number 3. Take it away, guys.
Moto number 3, Pro Runabout Box Stock. I'd be looking for Arminio Iataska to make a move.
And here we go. It looks like Miller with a great jump. Snyder, though, on the inside of him. I think he's going to pull that hole shot.
Miller takes it.
Oh,
Troy goes sideways. He stays on the boat. Tim Miller out of Waco, Texas, with a drive on the inside. Arminio Iataska on the outside. Oh, Arminio goes way wide.
Arminio on the gas, flying around the outside on that Sea-Doo. Miller on the inside. It's going to be Arminio with the head of steam. Arminio Iataska is going to take the lead. Number 4 down the front straightaway here at Naples with the whole shot and the lead.
There goes Brian Baldwin in third. Troy Snyder in fourth. Simon Belcher in fifth. Graham Hunt in sixth. Mario Lamy in seventh. It is a cast of characters out there out in front. Wide open, Arminio Iataska.
A cast of characters,
it
indeed.
It is a cast of characters.
Indeed, Arminio leading the way now on that black number 4 Sea-Doo.
Rick Lake, I just want to mention, at the end of the evening at 7 o'clock at the right behind the Tower of Power, we're going to have a band going.
All right, Arminio Iataska out in front and charging. He is going to have to... need a little bit of help to take this win, however, because remember, he started with a hand on helmet, dead engine start in the second moto. Otherwise, he'd be on his way to a world championship.
Well,
but
here's
Troy Snyder is in fourth right now.
Here's the crazy math, huh? They started with Arminio Iataska and Brian Baldwin tied for second, both with 5 points. Troy Snyder with 3 points. The way it sits right now, Iataska would win. Troy Snyder's got to get up into a second position to make certain that he can win the world championship.
Let's see, what does Baldwin have overall on this?
5 points.
So Baldwin's got 5, huh?
Iataska's got 5. Troy's got 3.
So Troy needs to get up to second place?
Exactly. If he's in third, it'll be a tie in the last moto.
Wow.
Goes to the winner. Absolutely. Right now, that's Iataska.
Oh, this
the
is
local
gonna be
rider.
Great. This is going to get wild, ladies and gentlemen. This is on the line. So Iataska in the driver's seat, but it's really going to depend on what Troy Snyder does throughout the rest of this moto. If Miller can maintain second and Baldwin third, that's going to give the title to Erminio Iantosca.
Can I just say that Erminio Iantosca's best friends are Brian Baldwin and Tim Miller right now?
He's loving those guys.
He loves those people from Texas and North Carolina, doesn't he?
Yeah, keep Snyder behind him, and he's going to buy all the pizza they can eat tonight at Mamma Mia's.
Well, I'll tell you what. The top four riders are all using that inside split. Troy is way back. He is fighting through a bunch of pump wash. Not an easy way to move to the front. Meanwhile, Iantosca, he's taking the outside. He's got that Sea-Doo dialed. It's hooked up, and he is leading this race going away.
You know, particularly in the stock class, very difficult to make up huge gains because these boats are relatively equal compared to, like, you know, GP boats that all have a different, they're all in a different world, really. And right now, Iantosca just absolutely dominating, as he did in Moto number one. However, it's Tim Miller in second, Baldwin in third. Baldwin's had a very quiet day, Kurt.
Yeah, he's, you know, he didn't race the pro GP class. No. I know he's put a lot more time into his son's racing. You gotta love it when a father and son are out here and they're both fighting for championships.
But this is the quietest I've ever seen a Brian Baldwin at an event. He really hasn't contended. He's been back a little bit, and it's very unusual to see. Usually he is up there battling for the win. But right now that goes to the hometown hero right out of Naples, Florida. It's Erminio Iantosca on that black rocket ship of a Sea-Doo leading his way around the track here, Moto number three of Pro-Am Runabout Box Stock.
No question about it. As I watch Brian Baldwin going on the inside, Baldwin is known for his using the brakes, using that everything that Yamaha's got to cut tight to the boys. But on this course, it's slowing him down. Tim Miller.
Yeah, Baldwin's going to give Tim Miller a tough time here. You know, in the next couple of laps. But Snyder's the one that's not really up with those guys.
No, and Miller looking over his shoulder at Baldwin right there. And I'll tell you what, it doesn't matter which way those two go. It's up to Troy Snyder to get into third. If he does, he secures a world championship. If not, Erminio is the one.
And Erminio right now heading down that jet trim, bitching, stitching back straightaway in charge on that Sea-Doo. Boat number four just rocketing around this race course. He has led from the start, pulled a whole shot, and he is gone right now. Tim Miller doing a great job in second place.
Wow.
A real fast rider out of Waco, Texas.
And watch Miller on the outside, because Baldwin's going to the inside and Baldwin's tearing it up. Baldwin wants to get by Tim Miller, and I'm gonna tell you what, unless Tim Miller can pull out some horsepower here, it's gonna be close. Here comes Miller, wide open. There goes Baldwin, not going to make it.
Yeah, Baldwin, not the speed coming onto the front straightaway that he needed. Miller on that Dean Cherrier-tuned Yamaha stock boat. And, you know, Dean got these things pretty dialed in, and he has won a lot of championships over the years on these with the Yamahas in the box stock runabout class.
Wow, Troy Snyder doing everything he can, and it's just not enough yet. It's surprising because he's been so strong all weekend long. I don't feel like he's going slower, but everybody else is going faster.
No, these guys are all championship-level riders, very, very fast, so nobody's going to give anybody an inch out there, and you can count on that. Certainly Baldwin's not. Tim Miller fast as usual, always a contender, but out in front, it's our race leader making the turn off the back split onto the front straightaway. Erminio Iantosca rockets down the front straightaway one more time on that number four Sea-Doo with the lead.
He's strong. Here comes Tim Miller. He and Baldwin get side by side, but Miller's got the speed. Troy Snyder on the 1-1-0 right behind him. Snyder, the world championship right in front of him. All he's got to do is pass one more rider, and he can be the world champion.
He has got everything in front of him, but yet it's a little bit of a distance, but he is closing that gap. He is going to have to mount a late moto charge here and try and get by Brian Baldwin. And those two have battled each other tooth and nail for years now, and maybe we're going to see that happen again here for the world championship. But right now, Iantosca out in front and in charge, hoping that Baldwin and Miller can keep Snyder behind him in fourth.
Well, Rick, I just used a calculator instead of the abacus because I'm looking at these points wondering if that's right. In reality, Troy's got to get to second.
Right.
Because otherwise, he and Arminio will be tied on points, and if Arminio wins the third and final moto, he's the champion.
That's right. So it's a tall task right now for Troy Snyder to get past Brian Baldwin and Miller.
Yes, it is. When we look on the far side of the course, Arminio Iantosca making the turn from the inside onto the jet tram, bitch and stitch and back straightaway. He is wide open, and Tim Miller right there behind him. Miller stretching his lead. Where is Brian Baldwin?
You know, you know, it'll be amazing. I mean, if Arminio hangs on and things stay as they seem, Arminio's going to make a clean sweep here in Naples and give Sidhu two world championships in GP runabout and stock runabout, which is just really amazing considering everything we've seen the last couple of years in these classes.
Oh, Brian Baldwin taking the makeup. Boy, that gives Tim Miller a little extra. And the 115 Gunner trailer going to have to move. White flag, one lap to go. This is it for Troy Snyder, the 110. He's got to go from fourth to second. Otherwise, Arminio Iantosca, halfway through this lap already, will be your world champion.
Well, I got to say, you know, Kurt, the Iantosca's, the Sidhu team down there on the beach watching. These guys are holding their breath right now as Arminio makes his way on the left-hand side of the racetrack onto the outside split section on that Sidhu. And it doesn't look like positions are going to change on this final lap. A few more turns to go, and the checkered flag is going to come out. And as I said, that's going to give Arminio and Sidhu a clean sweep here today in Pro-Am runabout, box stock, and GP. Wow, what a day.
I got to tell you, my heart soars for Arminio Iantosca. The boss is looking down. He couldn't be happier. His boy, a double world champion.
And we will be right back to speak with the winner.
Broward Motorsports, South Florida's premier power sports dealer with four locations, Davie, Fort Lauderdale, West Palm Beach, and Tequesta. A huge selection of new and used motorcycles, UTVs, ATVs, boats, trailers, and personal watercraft. Log on, check out the selection, and request a quote. Broward Motorsports will not be undersold. The best staff in the industry are ready to serve you. We also feature a customizing department to build the machine of your dreams. At Broward Motorsports, you gotta ride.
The Gulf of Mexico. I can hear my mama calling, just can't wait to get him back home. Way to the music. Spanish moss is moving slow. Come on, come on, Southwest Louisiana home.
What a feast. Spiced ham, carved turkey, prime rib on the weekends at a price that lets me treat the whole family. Doesn't get more festive than that. Or does it?
Prime rib weekends at Golden Corral. The only one for everyone.
These little cups would make great stocking stuffers. But how about right now in your mouth stuffers? Happy holidays to your mouth. Not sorry. Reese's.
With the money I've made on Poshmark, I've been able to pay for all our family's vacations.
I could pay for my wedding just on what I've made from Poshmark.
I've made over $10,000, and I was able to buy my new car.
Download the free Poshmark app now.
This is a clear aligner from Smile Direct Club. It takes teeth like these and transforms them into those. Join more than 500,000 satisfied grinners for only $85 a month at SmileDirectClub.com.
Drivers just won't put their phones down. We need a solution. Introducing Smart Dogs, the first dogs trained to train humans, stopping drivers from liking, selfieing, and whatever this is. Available to the public? Never. Smart dogs are not the answer. But Geico has a simple tip. Turn on Do Not Disturb While Driving mode.
Brought to you by Geico.
One shake and cats come running. So be careful what you shake. Temptations Cat Treats. All it takes is a shake.
And the checkered flag is going to come out. And as I said, that's going to give Arminio and Cedu a clean sweep here today in Pro-Am Runabout, Box Stock, and GP. Wow, what a day.
I got to tell you, my heart soars for Arminio Iantosca. The boss is looking down. He couldn't be happier. His boy, a double world champion.
Welcome back. I've got Pro Runabout Box Stock GP World Champion Arminio Iantosca getting it done in front of the hometown crowd. Back-to-back championships. How good does this feel? And how satisfied are you with this number four Sea-Doo machine?
It feels really, satisfying. I worked hard and, great setup. Alan Walker, my mechanic, really worked hard on the setup all year. And to win GP and stock in my hometown, really means a lot to me, my family, my girlfriend, all the support I've had over the years of racing. And of course, I'm extremely happy with my Sea-Doo. It's a great watercraft. My RXPX 300 was really hooked up out there, ran flawlessly, and I just couldn't be happier.
A dominating performance. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
This is how they finished up in Moto 3 for Runabout Box Stock with Arminio Iantosca taking the world championship.
Stick around later in the show. We're going to see some high-flying freestyle action. This is the Pro Watercross World Championships powered by Broward Motorsports.
Pro Watercross World Championships powered by Broward Motorsports on CBS Sports Network is sponsored by Jetrim, official seat cover and mat of the World Championships. By VP Fuels, official fuel of the World Championships. Make in power. And by WSM. Performance parts.
If you like having fun on the water, you're going to love Florida's Paradise Coast. From fast-paced water sports to leisurely, laid-back adventures, this place has you covered. And when it's time to come ashore, the action is just as exciting, with award-winning dining, luxurious spas, and countless ways to play. So escape to a place where your options are as endless as the water. And vacation well, friend, on Florida's Paradise Coast, Naples, Marco Island, and the Everglades.
Broward Motorsports, South Florida's premier power sports dealer with four locations, Davie, Fort Lauderdale, West Palm Beach, and Tequesta. A huge selection of new and used motorcycles, UTVs, ATVs, boats, trailers, and personal watercraft. Log on, check out the selection, and request a quote. Broward Motorsports will not be undersold. The best staff in the industry are ready to serve you. We also feature a customizing department to build the machine of your dreams. At Broward Motorsports, you gotta ride.
I'm a Verizon engineer, and I'm part of the team building the most powerful 5G experience for America.
It's 5G ultra wideband
for massive capacity
and ultra fast speeds.
Almost 2 gigs here in Minneapolis.
That's 25 times faster than today's network in New York City.
So people from midtown Manhattan to downtown Denver
can experience what our 5G can deliver.
And if Verizon 5G can deliver performance like this in these places,
it's pretty crazy.
Just imagine what it can do for you.
Shopping for my pets used to be so stressful, especially during the holidays. Oof. But with Chewy.com, I can get those big bags of pet food and litter delivered. So Dasher's dog food and Comet's cat litter can all land under the tree. And I barely lift a finger. Plus, with Chewy, it all ships fast and free. It makes the holidays that much easier. Now the only one lugging big bags around here is... Well,
get the gift of fast, free shipping on your pet food and supplies today at Chewy, where pet lovers shop.
Hey, hon, I'm going to go grab a pickup game with the guys, okay?
Okay, live it up.
Take in the car.
Wait, what? Have fun, sweetie.
Yeah, okay. I love you.
SmartLiner offer the ultimate smart protection. Easy removal, cleaning, and install. It's smart. It's SmartLiner.
Oh, yeah, the show is all about fun, but we still have to play by the rules.
Yeah, not happening.
That's intentional grounding. 10 yards. Loss of pick.
That other pregame show. Always the right call. Sunday on CBS Sports Network.
Welcome back to Naples, Florida. It's Sugden Regional Park. Let's check out Pro Ski GP Moto number 2.
Moto number 2, Pro Am Ski GP. On the inside, Dustin Motsur's first moto winner with a great jump.
Gone.
Heading
Cole
into
Kramer
the first turn.
Going
to be a hole shot. Cole Kramer, as you said, looking fast, but he's got company on the outside. No, it is Kramer with a head of steam.
Whoa.
On that outside split.
Cole Kramer on fire.
Oh, he
I'm
is
gonna
flying.
Call it right now.
He is
Cole
flying.
Kramer putting the pedal to the metal.
He may take the lead over Motsur's. Here
nope.
comes
Motsur's.
Here comes
got
Kramer
it.
With the head of steam. Mots looks over his shoulder, sees Kramer. Here we go. Mots out in front with Kramer right behind him. And then the Clipper in third now.
And then the other Motsur's.
Oh, Tyron's worked his way up from a rough first moto start. He is now. He is now in fourth place behind the Clipper, but out in front, it is Dustin Motsuris picking right up where he left off in moto number 1 with the lead. Cole Kramer doing everything he can to try to keep his commander boat on pace with the legend, Dustin Motsuris. Of course, Motsuris, one of the key figures and owners of Commander Industries, along with Steve Webster out there in Phoenix, Arizona. And a lot
so
of good things happening.
I want to point out that looks like Gawicki got stuck out there. Wow, I hate to see that.
That's Skellet out there.
Yes.
and Gawicki both down. Down the front straightaway. And look at Cole Kramer keeping the pressure on. Dustin Motsuris here, moto number 2. It's Mots and then Kramer. And here comes Clipper. Clipper trying to keep pace.
I'll tell you what, the Clipper, he's an iron man. His shoulder just barely contained after surgery
goodness.
A few weeks ago.
Absolutely
I mean,
brutal.
Weeks, you could count the days, and he's out there racing the best in the world. He's in third position right now, and he's got a Motsuris brother in front of him and a Motsuris brother behind him.
And Dustin, down the back straightaway, out in front, the Motsuris is really charging here as usual, no surprise. But Cole Kramer, the young rider
out
of Lake Calvasieu City, Arizona, 17 years old, really making a mark here in Naples.
Rick Lake, I've got a question for you. If it's,
shoot.
If it's one Motsuris, is it two Motsuri?
That's two fast riders. That's what it is. Two of the fastest
in the world. Oh, Kramer sticks it.
Kramer goes down. And here comes Clipper behind Kramer.
Oh,
meanwhile, Mots goes down the front straightaway, stretches it out. Kramer in second. And Clipper looking over his shoulder.
Tyron Motsuris has to hit the upright point. Clipper comes over in a veteran move and shuts the door on Mots.
The top four riders on Commander GP1s. And then here comes 100, Revan Harris on a Commander. 85, Jules Hopkins on a Commander. The 91, that's
he's
Gasparoni
on
a bullet hull.
And Camden Powell on a bullet. Commander under Isaiah Washington and Louis Vallée. Don't know what Louis Vallée's on. Kawasaki?
Could be a Kawasaki SXR 1500. Of course, I think every ski in this race, with the exception of Tyron Motsuris, are running Kawasaki 1500 four-strokes, the four-cylinder four-strokes put into these aftermarket hulls. I believe Tyron is still campaigning the turbocharged Yamaha triple four-stroke. If I'm not mistaken, that's what he's been running for a while.
Did you talk to him this morning, Rick?
I didn't.
Lake?
No, I haven't seen him.
Because that looks like a different boat. I think he might
it
be.
It might be.
I think he might be in the Cowie.
They may have all switched to Cowies. That's pretty much the deal now. That's the setup. They have proven to be fast, reliable, and they are really, really dialed in.
Having said that, I think he does better on the turbo.
I do too. Let's go down to the beach to Haley.
Let's talk about our 28-time world title holder, the 212 Yamaha machine of Mike Klippenstein. Now, he's feeling really good today. He loves this course. He's had a phenomenal year, but just a few weeks ago, he actually suffered a 4-inch shoulder dislocation. Now he's feeling back up to speed and actually went out and won the veteran GP class yesterday, which he used as a test and tune for today. Mind you, that was the first time his boat had actually hit the water. That's right, today is just that boat's second time out on the course. Now, he said the biggest challenge today is that it's really anyone's game. Just a few years ago, there were some rule changes that really shortened the margin and the gap between our turbo and non-turbo machines. He says we have seasoned veterans and young guns, and it's really up for grabs. This could be anyone's game, guys.
Hey, here comes 212 down the front straightaway, and you and I got to see the x-rays of Clipper's shoulder earlier today. It really was kind of tough to look at, right?
A 4-inch separation.
Oh, my God.
Imagine your knee going 4 inches down away. That's the distance that Clipper's shoulder was removed. And it took him a while. They didn't get it put in the first time. He said, man, it took him a while. It didn't hurt like heck.
I didn't like seeing those x-rays, to be quite honest with you.
No.
It wasn't pretty.
We'll be right back. Stick around for more racing.
Two different products that lower the temperature in your cooling system.
Great for bugs on the front of the car.
You got your wax here, you got your power wax.
Generators, pressure washers, lawnmowers, you name it, they got it for it. VP Racing is now offering Optanium Unleaded, which is safer for your street cars, safe for your O2 sensors, your catalytic converters, to get an increase in octane boost by pouring straight to the gas tank.
Former conference foes square off in San Diego. Cougars, Aztecs, Saturday night at 9 on CBS Sports Network.
Welcome back to Naples, Florida. It's Sugden Regional Park. We pick it up in Moto number 2 for Pro Ski GP.
Well, you can see it's getting rougher out there on the track, and those riders were very, very careful that lap over that log jump, really kind of taking it really easy to make sure they didn't make any mistakes. Both Tyron and Clipper did the same maneuver, kind of easing the boats, keeping their momentum, but not really going crazy so as not to lose any positions.
Yeah, any bobble here and you're going to lose a position, just as we saw with Troy Snyder earlier.
And these positions are so hard fought out there and earned on the racetrack.
Boy, look at this. Gasparoni. Oh! That double four, Camden Powell, right on Gasparoni, got in his pump wash. And here comes your leader, white flag out, Dustin Montsouris. One more lap to go for the Commander Industries pilot. He is on fire, folks. He has been untouchable.
Brother Tyron now in second place. Kramer in third, and then Clipper in fourth. 212 comes by. That's your top four.
Whoa.
Running here in Moto number 2 of Pro-Am Ski GP.
Tyron just came over that log jump a little hard. That could have been it, but he saved it.
As rough it is, as it's getting out there, that log jump really bobbing around. The skis are moving around. Your timing has to be impeccable to not create any drama over that log jump.
Well, Dustin on the back straightaway. Tyron going to follow momentarily.
Final lap winding down. Our race leader working his way around one more time on the inside.
Jules Hopkins going down the front with Isaiah Washington in tow. Those two have been battling. Here's your leader and your moto winner, Dustin Montsouris.
So this is how they finished up in Pro Ski GP Moto 2. Dustin Montsouris out front again.
That was a great Moto 2. Let's see how Moto 3 panned out for your Pro Ski GP.
Championship winded down.
Stand up.
So we are going to look at Dustin Montsouris. He is going to take this one. He's not going to take this race. Tyron's going to take it. Dustin's going to take the overall. And we'll figure out the math for the top three.
I pretty much got it. Cole Kramer, if he finishes third, he's going to be in that second position. Of course, we'll double check that at the end of this moto. And Tyron Montsouris, we'll have to see where he finishes. Potentially third.
And And that's what they're hoping for. And I think that's why, Dustin, I know that they wanted Tyron to win this.
And they did.
Tyron Matsuris takes the win. Number two out of Epinyani, South Africa, takes the win here in Moto 3. Dustin Matsuris knows that he has got a world championship. Kudos to number 50, Mats, and the entire commander team, Steve Webster, and all the crew back in Phoenix 202.
Cole Kramer comes across in third position. What a great ride by Kramer. You know, we appreciate all those West Coast riders, because let's face it, top three, all from our side of the country.
Absolutely, and we will be back to speak with the winner in just a minute.
And don't forget, stick around later in the show. We're going to see some high-flying freestyle action.
Everyone uses their phone differently. That's why Xfinity Mobile lets you design your own data. You can share 1, 3, or 10 gigs of data between lines. Mix in lines of unlimited and switch it up at any time. All with millions of secure Wi-Fi hotspots and the best LTE everywhere else. It's a different kind of wireless network designed to save you money. Switch and save up to $400 a year. And now get $250 off Google Pixel 4 during Xfinity Mobile Beyond Black Friday. That's simple, easy, awesome. Click, call, or visit a store today.
Attention cancer victims who use the weed killer Roundup. A federal jury unanimously found that Monsanto's popular weed killer Roundup was a substantial factor in causing cancer. You may be entitled to substantial compensation. If you or someone you love used Roundup and were diagnosed with cancer, call the number on your screen now. Don't wait. There may be time deadlines to file a claim.
Call 800-509-9652. That's 800-509-9652.
Glenn Helen always poses challenges for the drivers.
Jenny just smoked the left front of Doug Mattack.
Wow, now trouble for the 99.
Tough break for him.
Despite Kyle's missed chance in round 7, he goes into round 8 still holding the points lead. Find out if he can maintain his points gap here at the Lucas Oil Off-Road Racing Series. Sunday on CBS Sports Network.
And then Tyron Matsuris takes the win. Number two out of Epinyani, South Africa, takes the win here in Moto 3. Dustin Matsuris knows that he has got a world championship. Kudos to number 50, Mats, and the entire commander team, Steve Webster, and all the crew back in Phoenix 202.
Cole Kramer comes across in third position. What a great ride by Kramer.
Welcome back from Proski GP. I have Tyron Matsuris. Congratulations on the Moto 3 win. What did it take to get it done today?
The races were tough. I had hard battles all day. In the last moto, I was determined, I had a bad start in the first moto, and I was like, I got to at least win one moto out of the three. Dusting myself with teammates and brothers, but at every race, it's individual sports, and we both race each other as hard as anybody else. So it was great to get that win.
A job well done. Congratulations. Now, Dustin Matsuris, congratulations on the Proski GP World Championship. What was the secret here?
Yeah, honestly, good starts. There was a lot of tough competition. Cole Kramer was out here. He was on the gas the whole day, pushing me. Tyron, obviously, pushing me nonstop. So I needed good starts. I rode smart.
Congrats, Dustin.
Thank you.
You're world champion. This is what we've been waiting for. We've been teasing about it all show. Check out Pro Freestyle.
Gary's on the clock with a big backflip.
Here we go. Nice.
There's a double.
With a twist.
Okay.
The promoter. Our race director is losing his mind right now.
Race director don't like that.
Oh, what a backflip.
Nice one-hander lander. Gary Burka putting on a show here today. Now, that's a tough one. These backflips, you add a degree of difficulty. Dual backflips, one-hander lander, no-hander lander. Oh, nice.
A 360, 180, 360, 720. He keeps going.
Gary Burka, this is the best I've ever seen Gary Burka ride, is here today. He is looking strong, no question about it. All right, let's put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen. Gary Burka, Rolling Meadows, Illinois.
Wow.
We hope you enjoyed that as much as we did. From myself, Rick, and Kurt in the booth, thank you so much for tuning into the CBS Sports Network for Pro Watercross World Championships powered by Broward Motorsports. We'll see you next time.
some of the fastest race boats on the planet.